Hello my dear friends, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today I am going to describe teaching aptitude part 2. In previous video I have described teaching aptitude part 1. If you want that video, go to my description sections and you get the link. Let's start. Effective teaching by and large is a function of first option, maintaining discipline in the class. Second option, teacher honesty. Third option, teachers making students learn and understand. Fourth option, teachers liking for the job of teaching. Here option C is correct. Teachers making students learn and understand. Next question, who said this? Education is man-making. It is that by which character is formed, strength of mind is increased, intellect is expanded, and by which man can stand on his own feet. Option A, Swami Vivekananda. Option B, Guru Rabindranath Tagore. Option C, Swami Dayananda Saraswati. Option D, none of these. Here option A is correct. Swami Vivekananda. Next questions. Effective teaching includes option A, teacher is active but student may or may not be active. Option B, teacher may be active or inactive but students are active. Option C, teacher is active and students are active. Option D, all of the above. Here answer is option C, teacher is active and students also are active. Next questions. Which of the following statements is not correct? Here option A good communicator cannot be a good teacher. Option B, a good communicator has good sense of humor. Option C, a good communicator has wide reading knowledge. Option D, a good communicator has command over language. Here option A is the answer. A good communicator cannot be a good teacher. Next questions. A teacher is successful only if he, option A, knows his subject thoroughly well. Option B, produce 100% result. Option C, is approachable. Option D, published paper in journal of repute. Here option A is correct, knowledge about his subject, that is know his subject thoroughly well. Next question, a teacher will become an effective communicator if option A, he uses instructional ads. Option B, he helps students get meaning out of what he teaches. Option C, he asks questions in between teaching. Option D, he helps students get correct answer to the question on the topic. Here option B is correct. He helps students get meaning out of what he teaches. Next question, teaching in higher education implies option A, presenting the information given in the textbook. Option B, asking question in the class and conducting examinations. Option C, helping students prepare for and pass the examinations. Option D, helping students to learn. Here option D is correct, or helping students to learn. Next question, teaching will be effective if the teacher, option A, is the master of the subject. B, has much experience in teaching in the subject. Option C, start from what students know already. Option D, uses many instructional ads. Here option C is correct, start from what students know already. Next question, a college teacher will really help the students when she, option A, dictates note in the class. Option B is objective in her evaluations. C encourage students to ask questions. Option D cover the syllabus completely in the class. Here option B is correct, is objective in her evaluation. Next question. Which is the most desirable outcome of teaching in higher education? Option A, increase the student achievements. B, increase the level of independent thinking of students. Option C, higher percentage of result. Option D, increase in the number of students who opt for the subject. Here option B is correct, increase in the level of independent thinking of students. Next question. Books can be powerful source of communication provided. Option A, the content is abstract. B, the content is illustrative. C, the medium is Hindi. D, the content is presented through good print. Here option B is correct, the content is illustrative. Next question. Good teaching is best reflected by A, attendance of the students. B, number of distinctions. C, meaningful question asked by students. Option D, pin drop silence in the class. Here option C is correct, there is meaningful questions asked by students. Next question. The main aim of classroom teaching is option A, to give information. B, to develop meaningful inquiry mind. C, to develop personality of the students. D, to help students pass examinations. Here option B is correct, to develop inquiry mind. Next question. Students prefer those teachers who option A, dictate notes in the class. B, give important questions before examination. C, can clear their difficulties regarding subject matter. D, are themselves disciplined. Their option C is correct, can clear their difficulties regarding subject matters. Next question. Which of the following is the main objective of teaching? Option A, to give information related to the subject. B, prepare the students for examinations. C, help the students in getting job. D, to develop thinking capability of students. Here option D is correct, to develop thinking capability of students. Next question. The teacher's role in higher education is to provide information to the students. Two, only prepare students for examinations. Three, motivate students for self-learning. Four, encourage competitions among students. Here, option C is correct. That is, provide information to the students, motivate students for self-learning, encourage competitions among students. This is the answer. Next question. A new teacher to start with will have to option A, enforce discipline in the class. B, establish rapport with the students. C, cut jokes with the students. D, tell the students about his qualifications. Here option B is correct, establish rapport with the students. Next question. Effective teaching means all of the following except option A, a teacher teaches with enthusiasm. B, a teacher find fault in his subject. A teacher find faults in his students. C, a teacher put emphasis more on teaching than on class control. D, a teacher is interested in making the subject matter understood rather than on completing the course. Here option B is answers. A teacher finds fault in his students. Next question. A teacher who is not able to draw the attention of his students should evaluate his teaching method and improve it. B. Resign from the post. C. Find fault in his students. D. None of these. Here, option A is correct. Evaluate his teaching method and improve it. Next question. A teacher should provide overview of the topic to be taught in the class. Option B. Should have good communication skills. Option C. Should command over his subject. Option D. All of these. Here, all option is correct. Thank you very much. If you like my videos, kindly share and subscribe my channel. To see you next video again.